Only yesterday, I was barely 17, and I once killed a boy with a Fender guitar. I don't remember if it was a Telecaster or a Stratocaster, but I do remember that it had a heart of chrome and a voice like a hornet mange. I don't remember if it was a Telecaster or a Stratocaster, but I do remember that it wasn't at all easy. It required the perfect combination of the right power cords and the precise angle from which to strike. The guitar bled for about a week afterward, and the blood was soon dark and rich, like wild berries. The blood of the guitar was Chuck Berry red. The guitar bled for about a week afterward, but it rung out beautifully. And I was able to play notes that I had never even heard before. So, I took my guitar and I smashed it against the wall! I smashed it against the floor! I smashed it against the body of a varsity cheerleader! Smashed it against the hood of a car! Smashed it against the 1981 Harley Davidson! The Harley howled in pain! The guitar howled in heat! And I ran up the stairs to my parents' bedroom. Mommy and Daddy was sleeping in the moonlight. Slowly I opened the door, creeping in the shadows right up to the foot of their bed. I raised the guitar high above my head, and just as I was about to bring the guitar crashing down upon the center of the bed, my father woke up screaming, "Stop! Wait a minute! Stop it, boy! What do you think you're doing? That's no way to treat an expensive musical instrument!" And I said, "God damn it, Daddy! You know I love you.
You're the only thing. this old world that's pure and good and right. And wherever you are and wherever you go, there's always gonna be some light. But I gotta get out, I gotta break it out now before the final crack of dawn. So we gotta make the most of our one night together.
Then like a sinner before.